All right, I'll go ahead and kick it in.
Did you guys use all the that cranberry
Hi, everybody. This is Howard at Lounge Academy, WBIG.TV. Welcome to another evening's telecast, broadcast from the heart of downtown Buffalo's Lounge District. It's the beginning of a Lounge Academy episode here. We're going to watch it unfold right along with you. We have not received the script. We have not been allowed to read the guest list. We're going to be just as surprised as the viewing audience as the night unfolds. This is the part of the evening when, in the industry, we call this the introduction to the show, when not only do I show off the various camera angles that are available to me, at the touch of a finger, I could use whatever finger I want, and select whatever camera I want, whenever I want. And now, where was I before I... It's really overwhelming to think of that. But this is the, this is the part of the show where I'm always wondering, you know, it's kind of like Donut Tuesday TV show in a lot of ways. When we first start out, I'm always thinking it's going to be dull in an exciting, sensational way, of course. But I always underestimate what's about to unfold, as reality provides the best dramatization imaginable. You know, if you wrote a script and had a cast, you know what's going to happen, and we could talk to somebody like actor Dave Lundy about this, but you pretty much know what to expect from the night, and it's sort of a subtractive kind of synthesis where the participants in the production are kind of probably rating the evening in a subtractive, as far as things going wrong. You know, what's going to be deducted from an otherwise perfect score? Kind of like bowling. In your mind, you start out optimistic that the game's going to be a 300. And then you start deducting for the things that are not quite up to our hopes. And that's how, you know, a rehearsed show must be. I've never been in a production like that. I'm more of a spontaneous kind of person, the way I live my life and allow my friends to entertain me. Nice to see a guy there with his new little friend, his shotgun rider. And it's nice to see Amy out there as well, piping up. I see a lot of other people out there. They're not necessarily piping up, but they're tuned in. I'm not sure what it means when it brings names up in green. I don't know if you've ever tried this live feature. I think many of you have. I know Chris Green does. And he's taking a break from moving into his brand new shop facility to tune into Lounge Academy. It is a reality live feed, Mary, in every sense. And so anyway, at the beginning of the show, I'm always wondering if the guests that are here are the guests that are going to be here at the end. That goes for the home guests as well as the walk-on guests here in the WBIG-TV studios in the heart of downtown Buffalo. And Chris is still full of donuts, and he's a big guy. So that's quite a testament to the... Yeah, thanks for asking, Amy. I'd like to introduce the Lounge Cadets. Three of your favorites are here tonight, and they're over at the VIP table. Say hello for you, and for the new people here, I'll introduce them. Closest to the camera, with her back toward you, and the back of her blonde head, is Lounge Cadet Lizzie. And she's having an animated conversation with, to her left and our left, Ryan Lysars, president of WBIG-TV. And it's Ryan's birthday tonight. We're celebrating president of WBIG-TV, Ryan's birthday. So I asked him to bring a special cake for his own birthday, which he has. The third lounge cadet at the table who just got up to run some sort of an errand behind the bar is my co-host Mary Kunz Goldman. Looks like she was getting some paper towels as I provide color and commentary. Amy wishes Ryan a happy birthday. I think what I'll do now is I'll just, since the lounge cadets they're eating. Now, this is a special trio of lounge cadets. Not only are they very inner circle, but they're the three lounge cadets we have that can eat at the VIP table without breaking stride in their talking. They can just keep talking despite their masticating, and that's shows you what they're made of. I will now set the microphone on the piano, give you a split view, and I'll just start noodling around because that's what a cocktail pianist does at this stage of the evening. They play a little. Provide a little ambiance. Lizzie made a special dessert today out of model 1901 LR donuts. She made this huge presentation. We'll interview her later and ask how she did that. It's a beautiful looking and large, like Kevin Hayes says, with a D in it. Thank you. thanks, Guy, for listening. Sit back, enjoy. Hopefully you got a drink in one hand and a little puppy dog in the other. Feet up. I'm assuming you're not driving your truck. You might be. I don't think you'd leave that little pup home yet, though. The name of that tune is, it sure beats me. Looks like President Ryan Lysar, he's getting out of his seat. He's getting another glass of wine. Back to take his seat. Looks like he's heading over to the piano, ladies. We could be in luck.
The wine that you see on TV, it's just a prop.
Well, yeah, it's prop wine.
Yes.
It's Kool-Aid. It's like Jonestown around here. There's so much Kool-Aid. Ryan's digging into Lizzie's 1901 L Donut desserts. Ryan, show that. That thing to the home audience. It's huge. It's amazing. It's really in the spirit of the 1901 L Bar donut. Available every Tuesday. Yeah, we could. You could use that one right there if you want. Oh wait, it's here we go. Look at that, ladies and gentlemen. That's a model 1901 L lard donut concoction that Lizzie made out of a dozen donuts. Well, she probably made it out of a few less than a dozen.
No,
because something probably happened to one or two of them.
I ate one.
That's amazing. Does it taste like the donuts?
Yes.
But magnified. It's as if she...
And that's got a little boozy thing in there, too?
Just a little, not much. Orange liqueur.
Well, here's a little tip I'll give you, all the aspiring lounge acts. Get yourself the dessert and squirrel it away so when you're done with your shift, you could eat it. I'm going to show you how I do that. Now, did you add ingredients to this?
I added this is cranberry and then, of course, condensed milk and eggs.
Eggs?
Yeah, I didn't add any cinnamon or anything.
But I mean, like the volume of it is basically the volume of a dozen donuts?
Yeah.
Holy cow.
Yep.
I mean, that's...
No, it's hefty.
There are nuts in here.
Oh,
it looks delicious.
A couple pecans on top.
Delicious. It's really insidious.
Hi, Susan. Nice to see you this evening. I was just looking at this. This dessert, I squirreled away a little piece for myself, just in case the rest of the cadets eat it all. Although, good luck. Mary, you want to join me at the piano here? People are sick of looking at me here. Here she comes.
I'm drinking bodacious wine.
She's drinking, it's called bodacious.
It's called bodacious.
Well, how appropriate.
It is bodacious.
Well, you look lovely tonight, Mary.
Thank you.
Mary's wearing a nice little lounge outfit.
It's a beautiful night to wear lounge clothes because it's a little bit cooler outside. We're not the way we were some other weeks.
You never know.
Yeah, you have to speak up for the microphone when you're talking. You know, she's...
Beautiful night here.
It's like the first... I just realized it's the first time... How long have we been married? And we've been going together before that, like since 1998 or something. It's the first time I've ever had to tell her to speak up. What? Somebody write down today's date.
So he's telling me you got that loud German voice.
Her whole family does. It's a real nice trait in a person. You never have to say what. Although we say what all the time because we're married.
What?
So we tune each other out.
My sister went through a phase when she was a teenager or something that she said what automatically after everything. Everybody said, and my dad finally took her to get her earring checked.
Did it turn out she needed it?
She was fine, but she just kept saying, what?
It's just a habit.
What?
Like Ron Moss.
What?
You almost get the words out and goes, huh?
Yeah.
And then you fall for it.
Yeah, you're not even done talking.
You fall for it. Yeah, you catch yourself falling for it.
You start repeating what you're saying before you're even done saying it.
Right. Huh? And there's no reason in the world he says it.
The other one gets me, and somebody else will be saying it, you know?
Oh, yeah, you get that, too.
Oh, my God, it drives me too long, and all of a sudden I'm saying it. I've got to stop it, you know? No, I don't know.
Well, it's better than catching yourself talking like a valley girl.
Oh.
That would be awful, wouldn't it? Imagine that.
Oh. I don't want to criticize anyone's way of talking because sometimes I just can liken, you know, at the best of them.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm...
when I'm under stress.
The other thing that bothers me, because my father and he always say, baby talk. Oh. My father goes, stop it. Stop it. Because he had a secretary who did it all the time and he couldn't criticize her because you don't want to make fun of somebody.
Oh, man.
Why not? He used to make fun of her. I said, I'll make fun of like a little baby.
I was part of an act. We were on the road back in my vaudeville days, and we were playing in
Cape Cod.
Thank you, Mary. Mary was there.
I was not there, but I heard it. Cape Cod.
And they had another act booked that would alternate sets with our band. And the other act was a solo performer, and he was a professional hypnotist. Oh. Yeah. Oh. I've got his business card in an old wallet. He was this big fat guy. And anyway, I didn't believe any of that stuff, but after one of the nights, we were sitting around the room, you know, after the crowd left, and he demonstrated it, and I refused to be hypnotized because I like to be in control or think I am, so I didn't want to do it. But we had a our booking agent had just gotten engaged. And he sent his fiancée all the way to Cape Cod to watch us play, and so she could, just meet the club owner and just, you know.
Well, they're engaged and he wanted to...
Kind of keep things, you know.
Yeah.
So she was there. We had never met her before. And it happened to be this night.
It's a terrible story. I hate this story. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Oh, you don't want to hear the story. Mary, where are you going?
I'll come back.
I'll be back.
I'll put you on split screen, ladies and gentlemen. Well, I don't know how much of the story to tell right now. But anyway, the point I was getting to was that people under hypnosis, you're talking about somebody, your dad's secretary,
yeah,
who spoke like a little, you know, a little baby voice,
yes,
cutesy voice, kind of baby voice. That's the way this woman was talking while he had her under hypnosis, and he'd bring her out, but not out. He'd say, okay, when I get to 10, you're going to feel fine, but when we trigger you with this word, the word was jungle.
He remembers the word.
That she's not going to be able to keep her hands off the keyboard player in the band. His name was Howard. And he picked on me because everyone else in the band were these slick Niagara Falls Italian guys, right? Mm-hmm. You know, they were unembarrassable, you know? So it was naturally, so he picked me out to be the one, you know. And she had that, and they said that's what happens, or he said that, I think. And anyway, he got her doing all kinds of things. She just wanted to quit smoking. That's why she agreed to it.
Did she quit smoking as a result of that?
I think he forgot to tell her to quit smoking.
Gosh, I heard all that.
But he had her doing all kinds of things. And then he snapped her out and he told her, you're going to remember everything. And she did. And from that moment on, I believed in that hypnotism was a real thing. I was just always, I'm always skeptical about anything unless I see it. I just, what do I know?
Yeah.
I thought it was a magic trick or something. She was so embarrassed. You could not fake that. Actor David Lundy could not act that embarrassed on cue. So
I would never be hypnotized.
It was, I mean, he didn't get her doing anything, you know, that she'd regret for the rest of her life, but
yeah,
it was things that she felt, you know, foolish doing.
He shouldn't have done that.
In front of
people
that she just met that were actually business relationship.
That's not good hypnotist etiquette to do.
No, this guy had no...
It's not right.
He admitted.
And I've heard that in the industry they don't do that. They're not supposed to.
Yeah. Well, he was like the bad apple.
Oh.
And we were trying to get him to hypnotize girls, like in parties. But he didn't show up, so that didn't work. But
I have music trivia related to this: is that in Salzburg in the 1700s, the Mozart family was friends with the Mesmer family.
Oh, Mesmers
began the hit Franz on to Mesmer. They used to come over for dinner and stuff like that. Yeah, and his name lives on Mesmer,
yes,
as much as Mozart's does.
And Mesmer's dairy.
And Mesmer's dairy, probably greater.
Home of Zing for 5 cents a quart. Or 10 cents a quart.
I remember Zing. I remember being sent to the milk machines. It's so buffalo.
Is there anything special you came hoping to hear tonight, Mary Kunz Goldman? Now that we had a couple showbiz memories.
How about you do something to me, something that simply hypnotized me?
That's
a
good one.
We need a song about hypnotism.
Yeah, we'll get to that. We'll get to that song.
Tell me.
I don't feel like looking it up right now at the moment. Here's one. It's kind of a bold one to start with, though. Do something. Looks like it might be a quiet night here at Lounge Academy, which is
quiet nights. And
quiet nights. Song.
Antonio Carlos Jobim, I think. Yeah, was Wasn't it Antonio Carlos Jobim? Quiet nights and quiet nights.
Jobim? Mm-hmm. Mary knows everything about music.
Quiet. Yeah, I'm sure. I think. I'm not.
Well, that story went over really big about the hypnotist. We've got one viewer.
His name is Mesmer.
Only if Amy is a hypnotist.
We should do a hypnotist episode.
We should bring one. I should find this guy's business card. He might still be around if somebody didn't shoot him.
Hypnotized.
He would do anything for money as far as hypnosis goes. He said that to me. He said he had no.
Murder?
No, I mean, like, he'd hypnotize people to do whatever he's paid to hypnotize them to do.
There was an episode of Murder, She Wrote with the hypnotist.
Really?
You can guess what happened.
She quit smoking. Lost weight. Stop forgetting things.
I hear those ants.
Doesn't get nervous when they bowl. Or golf. This heart of mine was doing very well. The world is fine. As far as I could tell. Suddenly I met you, and I dreamed of gay amour. Dawn I woke up singing sentimental overture. This heart of mine is dancing gaily now. I taste the wine of real romancing now. This crazy world is taking on a wonderful design. It's life indoors, it's yours, this heart of mine. WBIG.TV. I hope the picture and sound quality are coming through from our antennas clearly. Maybe I can get the lounge cadets to come up and we can get a better look at them now that they're done eating. Or maybe they're just going to hang me out to dry up here all by myself. I have my leadership traits. I don't just get thrown under the bus.
I run under the bus.
Here comes birthday boy. He's also the president of WBIG.TV. It says that two people are watching, and it's hard to tell. See, now, some of the people are commenting, but it doesn't tell them if they're... Well, that'll be great, Amy. We'd love to have you as a walk-on guest here on Lounge Academy. We'll be looking forward to that. Now, it says two people are watching. However, there's a bunch of green names. I don't know what that means. Does it mean like they got like dangerously close to the video when it was scrolling on their window? We got Mike Beato's name is up there. Mike, are you actually able to receive this telecast at the moment? Of course, by the time they hear this, a minute rolls by.
Right.
We're on delay here. They don't trust us. And Wesley Carroll joining from his new home out west. Where are you? In Nevada or Arizona? Wesley, I forget. Oh, good. Yeah, Mike Beato is out there. He's taking a break from doing some stairs and some races. Do you have a race in the morning, Mike Beato? A run? Are they races or the runs? I guess they're both, right? Because
runs, races.
You win for, like, winning the race, so it's a race. Some are just runs where everyone gets a participation, right? You run and maybe, like, you survive it. You're a winner.
You run and you make money for somebody.
You make money for somebody else.
Yeah.
You run, but somebody else gets the money.
Right.
Where are you running from?
Good question. Two races tomorrow for Mike Beato. He's amazing. There's more miles on Mike Beato than on my Ford Crown Victoria. I'm joined at the piano here. I'll give you a little shot here. We can see that President Ryan Lysars and Lizzie and Lounge Cadet and host Mary Kunz Goldman. We're all at the piano. Makes the room look busier this way. We're enjoying that. It's kind of relaxing, isn't it?
Yes.
It's a great night. Great evening.
Yeah.
You could put some scarecrows in the seats there.
That's an idea. Might need them.
Selection at Kmart.
I should trust
them. you buy your costumes at the store, Ryan?
Sometimes. I did make the pizza rat costume.
Wow. Seven potential races this weekend.
Who doesn't like rats?
As the home audience collects tidbits of information over the weeks and years about the arcane knowledge of the Lounge Cadets, they already know that Ryan, he likes rats.
There's an audience of rats right here in this room. You just can't see them. Okay?
No, I don't think there are. I don't think the rats are around.
My sister once lived with one of her roommates had a pet rat. And the rat, I forget what happened, but the rat disappeared from
funny.
And the duct tape was trying to get out
through
the duct tape. So
or it's sad.
A week later,
it's mad. It's a good thing.
I could not stand having a snake.
Or it's bad.
How are you gonna have a snake?
But beautiful. For starting that off.
Got weird pictures. Those landscapes are weird that they have in there.
Thank you, Amy. You're
well, yeah,
a wonderful audience.
America is a salon. That's what it says. Yeah, that's a great picture of it. Do you know any of those guys?
Yes.
What camera angle would you like, Amy? Would you like we've got, here's your choices. You can decide, Amy. This is interactive, multimedia. This is the corner shot because the camera's in the corner of the room. It's not a bad shot for us right here. Then there's the shoulder shot.
We look like this wild.
You can see us from a little different angle. Mm-hmm. It's an over my shoulder. That's why I named it that. We've got the far shot. Probably not so good for this scene. It's from across the room. And then we've got this, the overhead, the drone shot. You can see this, but then you don't get to see the lounge cadets. And then we have the split screen where we get them all, but they're smaller. It's kind of like being a fly with 1,000 eyes. The night has 1,000 eyes.
Electric eyes are everywhere.
You tell me, Amy, which camera scene you'd like. Johnny Otts is with us tonight. Mr. Show Business from Virginia. Thank you. discover what chemical forces flow from lover to lover. How little we understand what touches off that tingle, that sudden explosion where.
Oh yeah, that's, oh, that picture there is the girl who chose the playmate of the month.
Yeah, that one there.
She goes, I'm happy, not just for me, but for Canada. You can tell I love this one a lot. Look at the caption that says, for Canada, for Canada. She chose the playmate of the month. Not just for
to discover what chemical forces flow from lover to lover. How little we understand what touches off that tingle, that sudden explosion when two tingles intermingle. Who cares to define what chemistry this is? Cares with your lips on mine what ignorant bliss is. So long as you kiss me and the world around us shatters, how little it matters, how little we know, how little we know, how little we know. That's called How Little We Know. It's great to see you, John.
Yeah, the Canadian thing.
Looks like Bill Jenkins is joining us, Mr. Lounge Party.
It's our Columbus Day.
Oh, Columbus Day, which is Monday. Canadian Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it's funny how they do have these dates.
Nice to see you, sir. Adjust the chair. This is called adjusting the chair in show business. Oh, my hair didn't get messed up tonight. Oh wait, I forgot. That's impossible.
Enough wild room there, right?
I always get hat head from those hats. He doesn't get them.
I wear a hair product cocktail.
It seemed like you were
I make a blend.
It seemed like you were going for a more natural look over the past few weeks, but now you're back to your cocktail, or did you have a different cocktail?
Well, it's kind of an involved story, Ryan.
Well, we can.
I changed the part on my hair. I moved it from
right
side to the left side, anatomically speaking.
So
and
it used to be parted on the other side.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I knew something looked different.
I did.
He
said I'm his wife.
He told me last week about it, yes.
People have been saying I lost weight. They don't know what's different. But for I've had my hair part. I've been parting my hair on the right for decades. And my hair specialists, who I've seen them come and go. I mean, I've been getting my hair cut a long time. They've been struggling with my cowlick. It's a funny name, a cowlick.
Picture a big cow on his tongue.
I just looked it up, so I never knew the word was actually cowlick. I think, was it Amy that mentioned the word? And I spelled it online, so I looked it up. And I always had to plaster my hair down, not just because I liked it that way. But if I didn't, my hair was like really wild at any length. And they couldn't, they said, well, it's this cowlick. And then they tried to do it. And the last time it started acting up really bad to where even with the hair product, the hair this summer was uncontrollable. And I even went back to my barber lady a week later.
Barber lady.
and had her adjust it, and she charged me for a whole nother haircut. That's how hard it was. And I just figured, well, I'll just wear it short, and, you know, it's going to be all over the place. And then I just had this, you know, when I can't figure things out, sometimes I just try things, right? So I tried parting it on the other side, and all of a sudden, like without any hair product at all, it fell perfectly into place. Wow. It was completely well-behaved, and the cowlick, like,
bowed down.
Didn't even care.
So you've been parting it on the wrong side for all these years.
I've been living a lie. So when I changed the part, I was kind of disoriented for a few days. Who am I? I started questioning everything.
Wow.
Yeah.
Right brain.
Yeah, did the two halves of my brain, where that they switched? I do feel more creative and less mathematical. If that's possible.
When you took the SATs, what did you score better on, the mathematical and the creative?
Oh, definitely not the mathematical.
Gene, you work with numbers all day, figuring out coupon discounts.
I can only do practical math.
I scored better on math.
Maybe it takes motivation.
I didn't know that Buffalo at first was supposed to be named New Brunswick. I mean, New Amsterdam.
No, I didn't know that either. That says that?
Yeah.
Bill Jenkins says he parted his hair on the right side when he had it. Oh, I see. Everyone else parted. I wonder if it has to do with being right-handed and left-handed.
1803. Oh, wasn't it?
Bill knew about cowlicks from an early age. Bill's been around the block. I see Mary Kate O'Connell's name popping up. Mary Kate, are you out there? Are you really out there? Great having you in the audience. I'd like to say hey there to Mary Kate.
Yeah.
Hey there. You with the stars in your eyes.
Yeah, we gotta keep that alive.
Love never made a fool of you. You used to be too wise. On that high-flying cloud, you won't throw a crumb, do you? You think someday she'll come to you? I better forget her. You're with her nose in the air. She hit you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care. Won't you take this advice? I am you like a brother. Or are you not seeing things too clear? Much too in love to hear. Is it all one ear or out the other? In love to hear, all going in one ear and out the other. Hey there, Lounge Academy. song that Gary Marino turned me on to use the drug parlance of the 1960s. I'm the only one that thinks my joke is funny. A lot of terms we use were like that like bankers and politicians use.
Yeah, people used to use those more like, let me turn you on to this music.
Right? I mean, it's become the syntax of our culture are these 60s like drug terms, right? A groove.
Yeah. In a good groove.
Feeling groovy.
Chill out.
Yeah, that's a great era.
How you doing, Mike Duffy? Nice to see you in the audience, sir. Happy Friday. It's a good day, Friday. For being here tonight, and
they always have it early. That's
she's off to some other show business
too early. They always have it
destination.
Something that day. I don't remember what it was, but it was. Oh, that was the day we found his bike ride, I think.
Oh, right. How'd they go? Was that hot?
Yeah, that was great.
It was hot that day, and stuff, wasn't it?
That was the only problem.
Would you do it again?
Yeah, I would. Oh, I just hope it wouldn't be 90 degrees.
So you went around and you saw all these cars?
Song for Mary. It's about people writing books. Mary likes to write books. If they asked me, I could write a book about the way you whisper. I could write the preface on how we met, so the world never forgets, and the simple secrets of the plot is just to tell them that I love you. As my book ends, how to make two lovers a friend. A lot of songs were written about friends that morphed into romantic situations. Monumental piece of work by Rogers and Hart from 1940 or thereabouts. A lot of great songs came from Pal Joey.
Yes, they were shipped from the farm one week, and I like them from Terry. Yeah, they're this weird little town. I love them. I love them. They said they were also called Rogers. Whatever they called them, I forgot.
Celebrating Ryan Lysar's birthday tonight. So I see Christina out there tonight through the camera. I can see her holding a big glass of wine in one hand. I can't make out what's in her other hand. Well, thank you, Chris. Appreciate that, Tina.
Next year I should be getting
the first cool night we've had all season. It's kind of comfortable, you know? Got the fire going over there. I think it's the fire, either that or the place is burning down. We're working our way through the Great American Songbook in alphabetical order. We're up to the I's. We started 7 years ago.
But do you think they would do better if they kind of combined forces?
Yeah.
How much could one
deliver?
Cole Porter was an amazing writer.
They ran away.
He wrote, Cole Porter wrote all his own words and the music to all those great songs. He didn't need help. He was also rich and he was a socialite. Yeah, he'd be out like cruising, like Lizzie's. He was out on cruises and he'd be writing songs on napkins and stuff. Until he fell off a horse, right? Isn't that what happened to Cole Porter? And then he.
I think he did fall off a horse.
And then he had like
he
back
got
problems.
Paralyzed. I think.
I know. I remember. I remember his life changed.
He was a wheelchair.
Yeah. What? Yeah. How sad.
I know.
The thing is, you know,
if you got
yeah, if you got life by the, you know,
don't
do stuff.
don't
do anything.
Do stuff, yeah.
Don't do anything.
Don't ride a motorboat or a horse. Private plane. Don't pilot a plane. I know that's how these people.
Tina likes that one.
Don't do.
I get a kick out of Tina. I get no kicks from champagne. Mere alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, should it be true? I thought Ryan was going to sneak away and light the birthday cake to surprise himself.
You just mentioned not getting a kick from alcohol. I had to go.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It is just prop line.
Your alcohol, that's why it's prop line. I like this one.
I get no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some get a kick from cocaine. I'm sure that if I took even one sniff, it would bore me terrifically too. Yet I get a kick out of you. I get a kick every time I see you standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's clear to me you obviously don't adore me. I get no kicks in a plane. Flying too high with some gal in the sky is my idea. It's nothing to do. Yet I get a kick. I get a kick. I get a kick out of Big Blue. Cole Porter from Anything Goes.
Omelets for the omelets.
And Anything Goes at Lounge Academy. Especially when Tina's in the audience. You know, it's a good idea to never make any plans. Right?
What if you have plans to make omelets?
She's making omelets for the Oblates tomorrow at 6:30 a.m. She's going to be at the Oblate house.
So I'm going to be up at 5.
She's going to be really tired.
Because
she's the only one here, so she can't leave.
Yeah, you're the only one here.
You can sleep in a few days when your sister's driving that car. I'll have to change Lizzie's plan. I should have realized there'd be another man. I overlooked that point completely until the big affair began. Before I knew where I was at, found myself on the shelf, and that was that. I tried to reach the moon. When I got there, all that I could get was the air. My feet are back upon the ground. The one girl I found. The one girl, the one girl I found. Phone the runaway, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to welcome Michael Beebe to the crowd tonight.
Oh, Mike Beebe is watching. Hi, Mike Beebe. I asked him if Henry is watching, though.
He's probably, yeah, he's probably lounging it up with Henry. Looks like Ed Lawson is out there somewhere too. I thought I saw him. And Gary Mooney? Didn't I see Gary Mooney? Had the craziest dream last night. Are the Moseses here?
Yes, the Moseses are here.
The Moseses are here.
Party's about to get notched up, ladies and gentlemen. Just what you asked for, ladies and gentlemen. Buffalo show business couple is on the way in the Lounge Academy. Kathy Moses and her sidekick, Nick. I saw Nick approaching the driveway with his feet. We now have no viewers. It's Nick, ladies and gentlemen, from the jury. The one he brought Kathy with him tonight.
I love your drawing on Instagram.
Oh, I love yours too.
That's great.
Nick's all bundled up. He's got like 7 sweaters on. It's good. I'll save on heat. It is cold.
I wore a leather coat.
Oh, you got a puffy jacket on. What's nice to see you, Nick.
I didn't wear
Nick Moses.
I'm still Santa. I'll be the last person. So.
Yeah, you'd have to use your imagination a little.
I was wearing them last year until it snowed.
There was 1 year I had the ambition of wearing them just kind of patchy for a long winter. So you always have that when it's good and it's nice for a while, and all of a sudden you're really beaten.
If you're hearing me speak right now, then you're watching a rerun. Because according to the Facebook little dashboard there, it says there's nobody in the audience at the moment.
Oh, there's nobody. That means we can speak freely.
Well, it means they're watching us in reruns, if they're watching. We do. We get a lot of high ratings in reruns. I love you. Echoes the hills. I love you. Dawn agrees. As once more she sees daffodils. It's spring again. Again, start to sing again the old melodies. I love you. That's the song of songs, and it all belongs to you, you and me. I've played this song a million times. I've never sang it before. Yeah. I love you. Hums the April breeze.
Oh, that's a beautiful words.
I love you. Echoes the hills. I love you. The golden dawn agrees. Or she sees the daffodils. It's spring again. Birds again.
Birds on the wing again.
Sing again the old melodies. I love you. Song of songs. From Mexican Hayride.
Hi,
I may be wrong, but I think you're wonderful. I may be wrong, but I think you're swell. I like your style, say. I think you're marvelous. I'm always wrong, so how can I tell? my shirts are unsightly. All of my ties are a crime. If dear in you I've picked rightly, it's the very first time. Wonderful, I think you're grand, but I may be wrong. Sullivan and Harry Raskin. Sounds like a couple of guys on my old bowling team.
I might be wrong. I might be wrong. But I think you're wrong.
I won't be
wrong. It's a funny title. I may be wrong.
Thank you, Mary Kate O'Connell and Neil Coker. Great people in the audience. Show business greats. Mary Kate, you should see Neil do some plastering. This guy taught me. He taught me how to plaster, for crying out loud.
Oh, where are you going to take them?
Showed me the shortcuts.
Oh,
what are you talking about? Are you?
What's that, Nick?
What are you going to do? I was thinking about it. Oh, okay.
It is. You know, I should get out there and do some plastering. I could do. He taught me how. I can do drywall without sanding. Not a lot of guys can do that.
I love seeing you drawing them.
No dust.
Beautiful work. That was it. You do good on the face. You did a great job.
You put it on and you just work it with the trowel and just, you know, it's a method. And you don't.
Kathy did a beautiful face.
You don't need any of that other stuff. Yeah, and you don't need dust and sandpaper. You don't make a big mess. You make a little mess.
It's really nice just to try this and try that and just keep going and doing it.
They've been so much.
Yeah. I sure am.
It's nice. Yes, you just go and you work on it.
Are the stars. Nick doesn't know if it's cloudy or bright. On account I only have eyes for you, dear. The moon may be high. I can't see a thing in the sky. I don't know if we're in a garden so am I. Maybe millions of people go by, but they all disappear from view. And I only have eyes for you. Cascade of applause. This is a nice song.
Still play that. I was never a player of it.
Three times.
I never read this one.
Three blocks.
But it's an ongoing thing.
Yeah.
They wrote so many. He only lived to be, what, 29 or something?
32.
32? How long did Break the Tide here? What age did Gershwin die?
I think he was 39.
39. We've got three different answers.
I'm not sure, though. Maybe it was
it's an auction.
Look it up.
Yeah, who's got it both?
If it takes forever, I will wait for you. Thousand summers, I will wait for you. Is that right?
Thousand midnights, I think.
Thousand summers.
Is it thousand summers?
Yeah.
I will wait for you.
Must have wrong.
No, right.
If it takes forever, I will wait for you. Thousand summers, I will wait for you. Back beside me till I'm holding you. Hear you sigh here in my arms.
I think you're making it too peppy. It's supposed to be really passionate.
Mary wants it more passionate.
What's Gershwin's first name?
I think you're right.
George.
By George.
It's by Michel Legrand.
Yeah, this is Michel Legrand.
Yeah.
I just think it's
he didn't do up tunes.
Yeah, it's just supposed to be very French.
If it aches day or forever, eh?
He ruins every song.
I'm trying to sing it in French.
Mary.
Sounds more like Piglet.
Well, they're all romance languages.
Let me get the answer.
Okay, we're ready.
It was 38.
Join in, everybody in the audience.
Happy birthday.
What a surprise.
Out in one blow. How old are you, Ryan?
29 again.
29 again, ladies and gentlemen. You're at WBIG 25. And it's Ryan's birthday again. Keep them coming, Ryan.
I see that song called Singing in the Bathtub.
At Lounge Academy. Ryan Lysar's birthday here at WBIG-TV. He's president, for crying out loud.
President of WBIG.
Bill Jenkins confirms it was 39 for Gershwin. I should never question Mary.
I thought the things at 38.
Oh, now hang on. Now.
Yeah, the Google said 38.
Bill, Mary says Google said 38, but I believe.
I thought it was 39. Maybe show
Bill and Mary more than Google.
Google wouldn't lie.
About
if it was 38 to him.
Bill says hi to everybody.
Hi, Bill. We're pretty close anyway.
Might have to ask Michael Feinstein. He's the expert on Gershwin's. Sleepless nights, the daily fights. Bargain when you reach new heights. I miss the kisses and I miss the bites. I wish I were in love again.
I love this song, it's funny. Oh, this is righteous and hard.
The broken dates, the weightless waits, the lovely loving and the hateful hates, the conversations with the flying plates. I wish I were in love again. No more pain. No more strain. Now I'm sane. But I wouldn't rather be gaga. Hold out for the cat's cure. The fine misunderstanding of him and her. learned my lesson, and I wish that I would love again. Clever song, huh?
Thank you.
Rogers and Hart.
That looks amazing. That's
from Babes and Hart.
Jeff Butcher's over there?
Yeah, put mine over there where no one will eat it. I'm going to have a feast at the end. Wow, that cake looks amazing. Ryan selected his own cake tonight.
It's got layers.
That's the way we roll. One of Ryan's responsibilities as WBIG-TV president is...
Oh, it is raspberry.
And he's taking this upon himself. He's in charge of the birthday cakes, which blow through here almost on a weekly basis.
Almost.
It's always somebody's birthday.
It's got raspberries on it.
We have another big birthday this week. I mean, just a shout-out. Jim Corbin.
Happy birthday, Jim.
Nice to have Jim for another year at Lounge Academy and many more to come.
Many more.
He had some big plans. I think Tracy had some big plans for him tonight. She's going to get him embalmed. So he never changes. Stay as sweet as you are.
See, this is what happens when you miss a birthday at Lounge Academy.
Yeah, if you're not here, you're it. We're like Facebook. If you're not here, you are the product. If I looked at Kathy and Nick began to sing, I'm not as crazy as Nick seems to be. After all, it's spring. And if I collect bits of straw and string, I'm only doing what those robins do. After all, it's spring. If I dream out loud when I'm in a crowd and forget the time of day, darling, bear with me when they stare at me and remark there goes an April Fool in May. Chocolate?
Raspberry.
The classic.
She always makes chocolate cake with raspberry filling and chocolate frosting.
Who always does?
I see.
This is sort of a family heirloom cake.
Oh, that's not Grandma Virginia. That's...
Oh, I get it mixed up. Okay. Because of the hearing.
Yeah.
Bill, are you still out there in the audience? Yeah.
I'm
just curious, not only because I know you jump in and out, but the Facebook dashboard says there's nobody out there. So if you're not out there, we can gossip about you. The Young and the Rest of Us. I'm gonna laugh you right out of my life. Laugh and forget this affair. Yes, I was foolish to care. So I'm gonna dance you right out of my dreams. Try and be carefree and gay.
Okay,
to thank Lizzie for making tonight special. I'm just gonna go home and start cooking. When our friends begin that heartless rumor, I know I'll really need my sense of humor. I'm gonna laugh you right out of my life. Make it a beautiful joke. No one will know you broke my heart. And if I find you and I really meant that last goodbye, then I'm gonna laugh so hard so that Bill's in stealth mode for some reason. He doesn't. So people are watching. Those numbers aren't right. We got to watch ourselves, Bill says. I've got a crush on you. Sweetie pie, all the day and night time, hear me sigh. I never had the least bit notion that I could fall with so much emotion. Could you coo? Could you care for a cunning cottage? We could share a world. Well, pardon my mush, Anacana. I've got a crush, my baby.
Yeah, that's kind of what they do now.
Thank you, Kathy. Hi, Shirley.
Oh, yeah, I know. Like,
wonderful to see you. And I see Ray Ammerman in the back of the room there, walking through. Huge show business. Maine and this town. Ray Ammerman, are you over at My Potato Pie tonight, or one of your venues out in the God's Country out there in Williamsville? It's a funny thing. I will get you. I get a thrill. I never knew. Isn't it a pity we never met before? Here we are at last. It's like a dream. The two of us. A perfect team. Isn't it a pity we never met before? Imagine all the years we've wasted. You with the neighbor. Joy untasted. You reading Ina. I somewhere in China. Happiest of men. I'm sure to be. If only you would say to me. Isn't it a pity we never met before?
I'm sorry, I'm
not going to let anyone. Gershwin and Gershwin from Pardon My English. Picture you.
Yeah, I don't know what happens to you, but I'm trying to tell the truth. But it's so funny.
Picture you. Upon my knee. Just tea for two. And two for tea. Me for you, and you for me, alone. Nobody near us, to see us or hear us. No friends or relations, on weekend vacations. We won't ever know, dear, that we own a
telephone.
We got Kavanaugh in the audience tonight. Day will break and we'll awake and start the day. A sugar cake for me to take. For all the boys to see.
Yeah, I love
it. We will raise a family.
how happy Kathy will be. They sing across the street over there at the U.S. Attorney's office all day long, right? They listen in on your phone, then they say, it had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around, bugging your phone. Somebody who could make me feel true. Couldn't make me bet big blue, even be glad just to be sad thinking of you. Some others I've seen might never be me, might never be cross, try to be boss, but they wouldn't do. Nobody else gave me a thrill. All your faults, I love you still. Had to be you, had to be you.
I was waiting for that extra.
Oh, wow. You did the face so well. You did everything so well. Where'd you get this from? What is this?
It's that.
Oh, that's great, Bill. With your new piano bench. Once I laughed when I heard you saying that I'd be playing solitaire, uneasy in my easy chair. It never entered my mind. Once you told me I was mistaken, that I'd awaken with the sun and order orange juice for one. It never entered my mind. I lack myself. Now I even have to scratch my back myself. Once you warned me that if you scorned me, I'd sing a maiden prayer again, and wish that you were there again to get into my hair again. It never entered my mind.
never entered my mind. Rodgers and Hart. Boy, that's a nice song. Thank you. From Higher and Higher, 1940.
The
Yankees, formerly owned by this building.
Yeah. That's right.
I remember. I remember. It's 0-5. I know they Red Sox.
You didn't get along with his partner.
So Red Sox are
the
winning.
One of them.
And nobody liked him, even his partner.
Oh, well, we like to think good things about the ghosts here. Maybe it was just the wrong time at the wrong place.
Many people didn't like them.
I like them.
Did you don't know?
No.
It might have been the wrong time.
I like them anyway. I should say yes.
Might have been the wrong place.
And then you try to make up with me.
Though your face is charming. What was the guy's name? Jimmy, Naples? Was it Jim Naples, the one that didn't like you?
No.
Jimmy thought... Oh, the other guy. The other partner. Max Margolis. Must have been Maxie. Thought you had the wrong face. It's not Nick's face. But such a charming face. That it's all right. With me. It's the wrong song, with the wrong style, though your smile is lovely, it's the wrong smile, it's not her smile, but such a lovely smile, that it's all right with me. Attracted to you, someone I'm trying so hard to forget. You want to forget someone too. It's a wrong game with the wrong chips, though your lips are tempting. Nick's got the wrong lips. They're not her lips, but they're just tempting lips. That if sometime you're free, here it's all right. Got a great audience here tonight. It's a small crowd. Just the way we like it. Gets crazy around here, isn't it? Last week was nuts. So.
Speak for yourself.
It's Nick. Dream away. while, scheme a while, we're sure to find happiness, and I'll guess all those things you've always pined for. Gee, I'd like to see you looking swell, my baby. Diamond bracelets Woolworth doesn't sell, my baby. Till that lucky day, you know darn well. Well, 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 baby, I can't give you anything but love. I can't give you, I can't give you anything but love,
baby.
My baby, that's the only thing, it's the only thing I have plenty of,
baby.
My little bitty baby. Dream a while, scheme a while, we're sure to find happiness. And I'll guess all those things you've always pined for. Gee, gee, baby, I'd like to see you looking something swell, my baby. Diamond bracelets Woolworth doesn't sell. Till that lucky day, you know darn well, 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 baby, I can't give you anything but love. Anything but love. Thank you. Thanks, Nick. Say neither. I say neither. You say neither. And I say neither. Either, either. Neither, neither. Let's call the whole thing off. I like potatoes, I like potatoes, you like tomatoes, I like big fat tomatoes, 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 chocolate, strawberry, let's call the whole thing off, but oh, if we call the whole thing off, we must part, and oh, if we call the whole thing off, we must break my heart. For we know we need each other, so we better know the hung off off. Let's cut the whole thing off.
Fred Astaire sang it.
Yeah.
At one point. I think they both
yeah, you're right. I think written by Gershwin, 36 and 37, renewed 63 and 64.
I just remember it was on my Fred Astaire CD, but I'm sure Sinatra sang it too. That's a cool song. You can do something other than calling up.
Birds do it. Bees do it. Even educated fleas do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. In Spain, the best upper class do it. Lithuanians, and let's do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. The Dutch in old Amsterdam do it. Not to mention the Finns. Folks in Siam do it. think of Siamese twins and Eftensteins without means do it. People up in Boston Beans do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. You gotta read fast to play that song. We've all heard it so many times, though.
It's a good song.
It's a wonderful song. There's a million verses.
No, there's the
some of them aren't dirty.
It's kind of chilly for the pedal thing, but I guess they're working on.
You know, we went to see that out of
yeah, these songs are versatile. You could do them up, you could do them slow.
He's wonderful. I went to one of his concerts a few years ago. I loved it. He's great.
Beautiful.
Everyone, the orchestra
is
beautiful. I'm smiling.
Oh, it's
so much fun.
He just
wants
to love life and be happy.
That's
oh,
good.
Great.
I
put
that on my
t-shirt.
Yeah,
and all the Johann
Strauss. Nick's very quotable.
I remember
it says today you can't capitalize on garbage.
Snowflakes raining down.
Unless you're in the recycling
oh,
business.
Man, it was wonderful.
It's a lot of money in that.
It's certainly something to remember. I mean, it's such a unique thing.
Because they know where to send everything. It's like we throw a TV set away, we're happy to get rid of it. But if we knew what we were doing, like we'd reach in, grab the big copper coils out of the back, and you'd send it somewhere.
And it's just entertainment that's 100 years old. You know, I mean,
you know, Nick, there's some girls just right for some kissing.
And
I mean to kiss me a few. Oh, those girls. I think they're all singing this in Washington, aren't they? Is this a song they're singing in Washington? Well, it is. I try to stay out of it. But I think they can all get together and sing this song. There are girls just ripe for some kissing. And I mean to kiss me a few. Oh, those girls don't know what they're missing. I've got a lot of living to do. And there's wine all ready for tasting. And there's Cadillacs all shiny and new. Gotta move, 'cause time's a-wasting. I've got a lot of living to do. Music to play, places to go, people to see. Everything for you and me. Life's a ball, if only you know it. And it's all just waiting for you. But a love, so come and show it. There's such a lot of living to do. Here at Big, Big Blue. This is a song like, though, the lyrics don't seem to apply these days.
Yeah.
Right? That's why you need a song museum. So there's a place where these songs could be studied and safely on exhibit where they can't hurt anybody and celebrated.
We will establish that.
We are. We are going to do that. We're going to, I think we're going to meld Lounge Academy into a song museum.
Hey, that's great.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah. People like museums in this town. You're gonna go, what, is the place full of songs? Yeah, hell yeah. That could catch on, Nick. Did you work this week, Nick? Did you? The shop at all? You're kind of taking it easy? Appetizing Nick, love for sale. Love that's fresh and still unspoiled. Love that only slightly soiled. Love for sale. To sample Nick's supply. Who's prepared to pay the price for a trip to paradise? Or Hurdle Avenue, anyway. Love for sale. Let the poet pipe of love in their childish way. Every type of love better far than they. If you want the thrill of love, I've been through the mill of love. Old love, new love, every love but true love. Advertising young love for sale. If you'd like to buy my wares, follow me and climb the stairs. Love, love for sale. Little song about retail. Reminds me of selling donuts.
Kind of racy.
Back in the day. He's saying here.
This was a racy song. Cole Porter wrote in 1930.
I don't know what that means.
From the New Yorkers.
Follow me and climb the stairs.
See, now they could be racy without, you know, they don't have to like get low brow. Right?
Right.
They do it with beautiful poetry that sets images in your mind.
Yeah, but everything's garbage now.
I know. Things are really dragged in the mud. That thing about the poet's pipe of love or something, I never really listened to that.
Yeah, let the poet's pipe of love.
Pipe of love.
Cole Porter. Who could have come up with that?
Yeah. I've known every type of love.
He put so many, like, things beyond rhyme, you know, that he puts in there, little things. I think he's wondering, you know, the clever little things he puts in there. It must have been a game to him, you know.
Yeah.
You could tell the playfulness in these songs.
I hope.
Cole Porter.
And he was such a wasp, right?
Porter,
from the Midwest.
He writes his songs.
Yeah. I mean, he wasn't some Manhattan.
Sounds familiar.
You had him in your chair?
Well, bet he did.
He was 1 century ahead of time.
George Barry is just tuning in, ladies and gentlemen.
Is he still out at the beach?
Are you out at the beach, or you're probably at home, right?
Is he back home? No, now because it's getting a little bit chilly.
I don't know. We've been getting such mixed up weather. Might have headed to the beach knowing we're heading into warmer weather in the weekend. Love me or leave me. Let me be lonely. You won't believe me. I love you only. Rather be lonely. Happy with somebody else. You might find nighttime the right time for kissing. Nighttime's my time for just reminiscing. Regretting instead of forgetting with somebody else. There'll be someone unless that someone is you. I intend to be independently blue. I want your love. Don't try to borrow to have it today. Give back tomorrow. My love is your love. No place, nobody else. Myself out gazing at stars. Hearing guitars like someone in love. Lately the things I do astound me. Mostly whenever you're around me. Lately I seem to walk as though I had wings. I'm bumping into things like someone in love. Each time I look at you, I'm limp as a glove and thinking like someone in love. I'm feeling like someone in love. Someone in love.
like someone in love. Ryan's old-fashioned. He likes old stuff. He digs the old-fashioned things. The sound of rain upon his windshield pane. Starry sighs at April bring. Remember that.
Right.
Well, we don't know who's out there tonight. We're not getting a lot of comments, but we know they're out there. A lot of people are like to tune in the show and make out.
We should all go.
I'll be there.
Let's all go to baseball. Kenny and I will go together.
Yeah. Oh, the ball games. Take me out to the ball game.
Yeah, next year. Now that I'm a free woman.
Oh, I see. It's a big.
That's right. Yeah, we don't pay.
Yeah. Walked right in and drove the shadows away.
Yeah, I had a full day on Dingus Day.
Love.
And I never paid to get in anywhere.
Walked right in and brought my sunniest day. He nodded. Once for yes.
We should all go for drinks and have a swallow. I would like to do that. Yeah, I'll have to get
here for anything. It's good. He knows a lot of tricks.
I found my car out to have a happy swallow.
Yeah, no, it's good. It's all right. He knows how to be a sidekick on TV. Stealing the scene every time. Nick, what a day. Fortune smiled and came my way. Making love and never thought I'd see. I'm so lucky to be me. What a night. Suddenly you came in sight. The way I hoped you'd be. I'm so lucky to be me. Leonard Bernstein was involved in the. He wrote the music.
Yeah, it's right near St. Luke's Mission of Mercy.
Leonard Bernstein.
She's loving his echo.
Yeah.
The Jewish guy waving the sticks around. That one. What a day. He was a clever writer, you know, he's really different.
Amy, that was amazing.
For a smile that came my way.
I didn't realize what was going on. I never thought I'd see. Someone who really loves her.
I'm so happy to be named. Ready, Nick, for the big number? Ready to do your high kicks? He could probably do them. Come on along and listen. listen to the lullaby of Broadway.
This is another one of my favorites.
They parade the ballyhoo, the lullaby of Broadway. The rumble of the subway train, the rattle of the taxis. The daffodils had entertained at Angelo's and Maxie's. When the Broadway baby says goodnight, it's early in the morning. Man, baby, don't sleep tight until the dawn. By Broadway, hidey high, the hoop-de-doo, lullaby of Broadway. The band begins to go to town, and everyone goes crazy. You rock by your baby round till everything gets hazy. Hush, bye, I'll buy you this and that. You hear a daddy saying, and baby goes home to her flat. To sleep all day. Good night, baby. Good night. Milkman's on his way. Sleep tight, baby. Sleep tight. Let's call it a day. Listen to the lullaby of old Broadway.
Oh, that was sweet. I love the start of that movie.
Thank you.
It has a little face. And it gets,
yeah, it's just,
yeah.
It's amazing. It's
the
height of
the old milk thing.
Movie making.
Genius.
Genius, and they did it.
How old did you have?
Busby Berkeley did all that. Those effects and everything, they didn't have a computer. You know? He had to sit there and like figure out tricks to do it.
It was all talent.
And he got all those legs all over the place. Like glide, like they were those kinescopes, is that what they're called? What are those things called? You look through kaleoscopes? Elaborate. And he used to cut the hole. He couldn't get the high enough shot to get all their legs. Cut holes in the ceilings and they put the stuff on the roof for the cameras.
My name is Quince, K-U-N-Z, like my name.
Oh,
and it was from the Paul Favre.
And they're all spreading their legs and going spinning around.
Some stuff, and it ended up that was the office manager's name was Quince for a long time. And so the employees
and those young girls, those chorus girls in those movies were full of future of the biggest stars. Ginger Rogers looked like she was like 16.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow, neat. Okay, yeah. Well, they're office manager for many years. And
you could tell they were going to be stars.
That,
you know, when you see
Ginger
Rogers doing her little thing, and the way she did it was so so good. No, it looks, it must be.
It's crazy. I know, it's just funny to see these. And I noticed because it was my name, and I was, you know, biking fast, and I saw. We should go together to Forest Lawn and do some drawing.
Well, we're a ship without a rudder. Greg Evans.
It's a weird cemetery.
Well, it's 9:35 here on the East Coast.
Yeah, I know. Now it discourages.
Probably,
you.
I mean, if we go another hour, I mean, that's
really
that would be
no,
maybe even longer. It depends, you know, if some lounge cadets come in, the room could completely change. You know, and then we got to.
I notice when I'm on a bike, it goes down.
So but we'll be in reruns. You'll be able to watch this. It'll digest it for a few minutes, but the Facebook will spit it out again, and you can watch it as a rerun.
In one of those, I don't know, they're not mausoleums, whatever.
Yeah.
But then they have like a little.
A happy swallow. Tina's listening to your conversations.
That is funny.
Which she should be doing.
Because sometimes I've gone there to draw and I pack a
Here's one for you, Tina.
Yeah.
The night is bitter. The stars have lost their glitter. The winds grow colder. Suddenly you're older. All because of the man that got away. Karen Lizzie back. She's home cooking. Tuning in to Lounge Academy. She's been on both sides of the camera tonight. I had a weird dad. I said, teach me the stick. He says, we don't have time for that. Let's teach you to drive a car.
I'm wondering, and I see things, but it's kind of funny. The more I see you, the more I see you.
just grows and grows with every sigh, I become more mad about you, more lost without you. And so it goes. Can you imagine how much I love you? The more I see you, as years go by, can only be you. My arms can see you. My heart won't try.
Horseshoe.
I need to get an eye patch.
Yes.
For what?
An eye patch.
My Kindle is older. Okay. You know what? Amazon doesn't want me to be on there anymore. They want me to upgrade.
Oh, for what?
Because I can't get on Amazon because they won't guarantee the safety of my credit card.
Oh.
They want me to upgrade now. I've had it for like 5 years.
Send them a U.S. money order. A savings bond. Traveler's check. Wonder if you can still buy traveler's checks.
I remember those. Yeah, those are funny.
They're good forever. I had one. I had few. I had some left over from a trip. I
used them years later.
I used mine. It was like, I think it was over 20 years later.
Yeah, I think I had one of those situations also, Howard. Yeah, where I had...
I figured, yeah, I got them, you know.
Yeah, when I got desperate for money at some point, I remember these old traveler's checks.
I think I started to worry that, like, you know, these people won't even been born that know what they are, and they won't cash them.
Because I'm not sure they'd be good for anything now, so it's good that we used them when we did. I know, it was fine.
Yeah.
What was that? Could you
traveler's check.
Yeah, traveler's text. I don't think they exist anymore. Yeah, you used to buy them when you went overseas and everything. You'd buy your traveler's text and you'd cash them in.
They've got some paper savings bonds.
They've got what?
They have some paper savings bonds.
Well, those still hold up, I think.
I'm waiting to cash them in.
I did, yeah.
Have they matured yet? Yes.
No, they're going to fully mature in 2022.
Oh, keep up till then.
Those are a good deal.
Yeah.
We had some. She lost them.
You know, you can still
you can't
get
lose them.
If you, even if you lose
if
them.
If you have the numbers, right?
Howard was telling me you could still
oh,
get them.
I don't have the numbers.
They're associated usually
I
with
think
the
they might have your name
number.
Or something. Maybe
they
have I would look into it, though.
Really?
So
they
have
social security number on them.
They exist
yeah,
somewhere.
Yeah, they all have social security numbers.
Yeah, look them up.
Number.
Yeah, definitely
oh,
look
well,
into it.
Oh, they should
it.
Be
yes.
able to cross-reference
yeah, there's got to be some record. Yeah, look up. Even if you lose them or throw them out.
She wanted to take my cigarette.
No, definitely pursue it, Dave. Social Security number.
My
they're on record somewhere.
That's funny
Valentine.
Yeah. Sweet.
Yes.
Yeah.
Comic Valentine. You make me smile with your eyes. Your looks
yeah,
are laughable.
Somebody paid for them, so they're out there. It's like you give them to they're out there.
Yeah,
photographable. Yet you're my favorite work of art. Is your figure less? Is your mouth a little weak when you open it to speak?
Well, no, that shouldn't be the end of it.
Yeah.
Are you smart? Don't shame. For me, stay a little Valentine, stay each day is Valentine.
Want to see modest mouse?
You want to see modest mouse?
one look at you. That's all I meant to do. And then my heart stood still. My feet could step and walk. My lips could move and talk. And yet my heart stood still. Though not a single word was spoken, I can tell you knew. The girls of hands told me so well you knew. I never lived at all until the thrill of that moment when my heart stood still. That moment when my heart stood still. Rogers and Hart, a Connecticut Yankee. What about the what?
I don't want to talk to the camera. I'll tell you later.
If I don't see her each day, I'll miss her. Gee, what a thrill. Each time I kiss her. I've got a case. Nancy with a laughing face. She takes the winter and makes it summer. Summer can take some lessons from her. Picture a tomboy in lace. With a laughing face. You have that on her. Mission bells ringing. Give you the very same
clothes.
Hear her say hello. Goodness, you can't resist her. Sorry for you, she has no sister, no one could ever embrace Nancy with my laughing face.
Welcome to Lounge Academy, ladies and gentlemen. This is the end of the night where we, the core group, sits around and gossips about the people that aren't here. And we discuss the great songs of the 20th century.
Oh.
Looks like we lost a signal or something. Let's see.
The one out that the priest got. Yeah.
See if we're still on here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, was that? Was that?
Looks like we are. Okay.
Capitalize on this chaos.
The main control screen of Facebook shut down. So I wasn't sure if we're.
Seems like that knows we should check up.
Looks like we're still live, though, right? I just can't see all the comments.
I'm on the anarchy.
And we got a maybe. If you need some goodwill or something,
well, we think that.
On a clear day. Rise and look around, Nick. Ball this building. What are we doing saving other buildings? What about ours? We won't have a place to save those other buildings from.
But at least I learned a new word. Eminent domain.
Yeah, yeah, I wish I didn't know that word.
I know.
It's very clear. Our love is here to stay. Not for a year, but ever and a day. The radio and the telephone, the movies that we know may just be passing fancy. And in time may go, but oh my dear, our love is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. Crumble. Gibraltar may tumble, they're only made of clay. But Lounge Academy is here to stay. Is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. In time the Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble, convention center only made of clay. But our Lounge Academy is here to stay. Thank you, Nick.
Where did that come from? Oh my gosh, that's amazing. You can open schools, donation. That's recent. You're the top of the world in 50 years.
Oh, pistachio nuts, too late, I saw them. Wow. How great, thanks, Kathy. Are they salted? Lightly salted or salted and roasted?
Salted and roasted.
That's the... Yeah. Please don't talk about Nick when he's gone. Oh, honey, though our friendship ceases from now on, listen if you can't say anything real nice. Oh, baby, it's best not to talk, that's my advice. You go your way, I'll go my way, that's the best we can do. Here's a kiss, hope it brings lots of luck to you. Makes no difference how I carry on. Please don't talk about Nick when he's gone, he's gone. Don't talk about Nick when he's gone. He won't know, unless he goes home and watches. Wonderful. It's marvelous. Good night, Kathy Moses. Thanks for bringing Nick. Thanks for keeping him from, you know, wrecking the place. He's reminding me to do my stretching exercises. You're right. I will. I do those. Those things really help. It's all you got to do. You don't have to go to the gym. I do them with the cat.
10 minutes.
Yeah.
Every morning.
I do it for about a minute.
And I still don't have anything down there.
Yeah. Keeps you out of trouble. Well, that's good. Nick Moses. Nick Moses, ladies and gentlemen. One half of the show business team of Nick and Kathy Moses. Ryan Weiser is president of WBIG.TV and the birthday boy tonight. Thanks for bringing that great cake for you. I can't wait to have the piece that I squirreled away, even though I'm on a diet. It's only Ryan's birthday, I think only once a year, right?
Sometimes a few times a year.
I think this year is once.
Yeah, just once. It's been known to happen more than once. We've had 3 or 4 cakes here on different weeks, you know.
We have.
But not this year.
No, I can't. That cake looks so good. I can't wait. I'm glad I get a piece, and I'm glad I only get one piece.
I was just going to ask, do you want more?
I do, but don't let me have it. Don't let me... Don't listen to anything I say when I'm like this.
Okay.
I'm on a lard diet.
That's the latest trend in weight loss, is eating lard by the spoon, right?
It is.
When you get those cravings during the day, between meals.
Right.
Don't give in.
No.
And eat something you'll regret.
No, you don't want to do that.
You have a spoonful of
lard. Because it makes it worse. You have something sugary, and then you're really off the tracks.
And that lard will keep you going for a couple hours, huh?
It does. I mean, you can't, I found you can't just like eat just lard. I don't know, understand the nutritional value of it. I tried looking it up and I didn't understand it. I mean, it definitely has a lot of food energy. But I've actually crashed. Like I'd eat a little bit and go around, like go for a walk around the park a few times and stuff, to where I figured, well, I know I'm going to be hungry, and that'll, like, so it carries me. And then if you go too long on too much lard,
we're talking about lard.
Man, when you do, when your blood sugar does drop, it's like panic time. And so you got to be, that's strong stuff.
So lard isn't the only answer.
No, I haven't tried like just like existing on it. It's more like a supplement. Supplement.
Yeah, it's like a vitamin.
Yeah, I suppose.
A spoonful of lard a day keeps the doctors away.
It does really stabilize your sugar. For those in the audience, you know, if you've got a, if you look down and you see a big gut, like I have, but and I used to have a bigger one up until very recently, then you're a prime candidate for this lard diet. And write us. Send a postcard to WBIG.TV, Delaware Avenue, Buffalo, and we'll tell you all about the lard diet. Well, I guess we're heading into the epilogue. That's where just Mary and I talk and kind of sum up the evening.
Ryan's waiting to be excused.
Enjoy.
Well, thank you, Ryan. Happy birthday again.
Thanks.
It was a great birthday party tonight. I enjoyed it.
It was intimate.
It was intimate, as they say. The epilogue, checking to see if anybody is...
Is anyone watching?
I don't know. Jeremy says super dark. I don't know if he's talking about the picture or our picture or the picture of his car. But I'm looking at us and we're not super dark. I see a beautiful, pristine picture. Oh wait, one of the cameras isn't... Oh, here we are. That's because there's a time delay. Our main screen blew up, so we don't have the main control. So I'm just watching it like everybody else. And which isn't
this bad. Is a nice night tonight. I really enjoyed myself.
Oh, thank you,
really
Mary.
Fun, this
Me too.
I mean, just a small group of people, but a lot of fun.
It is. I enjoy these small nights. Quite nice.
The Dave Frischberg song, Small Day Tomorrow. This is a small day. It's nice.
Especially when it's with, you know, old friends.
It's a beautiful evening.
It's nice when, you know.
And celebrating a birthday. It's just fun.
It was nice of Kathy Moses to leave me that huge giant bag of salted pistachio nuts.
No, I was trying to hush her up.
That my friends were trying to talk her out of giving me.
No, I wasn't trying to talk her out of giving it. I was trying to just hush it up so I could stick it in the back somewhere and bring it out.
Oh, to surprise me?
Yeah. No, I didn't want to not deprive you of it, but...
Yeah, well, I busted them anyway.
I wasn't trying to tell her to take them away.
It was becoming like a Shakespearean plot. It's like there's a few dishes to do, but it isn't too bad. Looking ahead to the some of the behind-the-scenes show business stuff that goes on here when we close up. At the end of one of these shows, I hope Jim Corbin had a nice birthday today, right?
I hope his birthday.
Well, his birthday was a day or two ago, but we celebrate all birthdays on Fridays.
Yeah, we had great fun at his expense last year.
Yes.
When it was
a huge party for him.
And he wasn't here, and we were texting him, and then we were ridiculing his decision online for him not to be here.
Yeah, we took it easy on him this year.
Yeah.
Somebody else's turn.
I see that City of Buffalo Department of Coffee and Donuts official mug sitting there.
Oh, yeah, this one here.
Where did that come from? How come that's here?
Well, in the show business world, they call this product placement.
No, so it was sitting there for product placement.
So it's Lounge Academy, the show, yet I'm drinking out of a mug that's for Donut Tuesday, which is also a TV show that we produce at WBIG.Tv. It's on every Tuesday. It starts around 11:30 in the morning. Runs a couple hours here on WBIG.Tv. Here's the other side. And if you play your cards right, you'll be wrapping your lips around one of those.
Sipping your coffee out of
it. I like one. I took one back to my... I went out of my way this week to buy one for myself from our gift shop at the old house downtown. Because I really like them. You know, I reacted the same way as our friends do, you know. And I bought one and took it back to the shop. And it's fun having coffee over there out of it.
Nothing more fun than having coffee.
No, that is fun. It's fun to see how much you could drink.
Yeah. How much coffee you
can of coffee, that is.
It's just
a we're not testifying here to Congress and talking about other things. Maybe we should call it a night then. And,
this is a really nice night. I almost hate to call it a night because it's been so much fun. It's been great. I've really enjoyed this.
It was a nice night. All right. Well, thank you, everybody, for helping to make this a great night. I appreciate all the comments and requests that we were getting through the night.
this was fun tonight. Nice evening.
Not sure if the comments are. I don't have my main screen, the official screen that tells me who's out there. So if you don't pipe up, I can't see you. But I see there's some curiosity seekers walking down Delaware, looking in. They're just gonna have to wait just a little while longer, and we'll be making an announcement, and we're gonna have. We're going to have a thing like this for the public.
It's going to be beautiful.
If we get it done before they you know, seize the building and demolish it for a convention center.
There was a nice set that we played all night. You played some beautiful songs.
Oh, thank you, Mary. Appreciate that compliment. Oh, Well, good night, everybody. I'm gonna do the dishes. You know your way out. Be careful going out to your cars. Drive carefully. At Lounge Academy, it's just you and me, and the World Wide Web. Well, when I'm done with the dishes, I'm thinking ahead. I'm like a chess player. I think a few moves ahead, and I'm thinking, when I'm done cleaning up, I've got the dessert that Lizzie made out of 1901L donuts. She bought a dozen donuts and made this huge dessert out of them and brought them in. And I haven't tasted it yet.
It's
a bread pudding. A large bread pudding.
With orange liqueur glaze on
it. Orange liqueur.
Orange liqueur.
Wow.
It is so good.
And then we've got some kick-ass, to use 60s parlance, chocolate birthday cake.
Oh, that is so good.
What does that have, cranberry or something in there?
It has a raspberry.
Raspberry filling.
It's from Wegmans. It's really good.
And then there's, what else? There's steaming hot loaf that I didn't eat yet.
There's,
I got
that too. And there's
slice of that with lard in there. And shrimp creole for y'all. Well, and then there's that bag of pistachio nuts.
There's so much.
I must be hungry. I'm just thinking about food. We'll go to Food Academy. Well, we'll see you next week, everybody.
Good night, everyone.
Have a great weekend, a great week.
Beautiful week here.
Don't make any plans. And we'll,
this is a really nice night tonight.
Maybe we'll see you Tuesday at Donut Tuesday. Tune in right here, the same station. And you can watch us selling donuts to people on the sidewalk with our booth. It's kind of fun. We have some interesting conversations with strangers. They're no longer strangers.
They're friends.
We're getting to know like everybody downtown. And then if we don't catch you on Tuesday, we'll see you again here on next Friday around 7 o'clock on the East Coast. I'm going to use my finger, press the button, and we're going to vanish. We're going to alter reality with my finger. Here we go.